ready.
Good morning, everyone. I'm Karen Joy, and I am the creative source behind Handsœwn and Butter of Bespoke Bake Shop. So I'm here today to tell you about the guided experiences that I create for people to help restore, repair, and heal their connections to each other and to the natural world that we are all part of. So I do forest bathing, farm, food, and fiber arts. It's kind of a lot. I'm a certified nature and forest therapy guide through the Association of Nature and Forest Therapists. I'm also an organic farmer. I have a bachelor's degree in fashion design from Washington University. And so I express myself in a lot of creative ways. But what I want to talk today, and I think it's very interesting that 1 million cups, one of your moments that stood out in your introduction, was that you create authentic connections, and connections is exactly what I'm working to repair. We've all been through trauma over the last couple of years, even if you're not fully aware of that fact. This has been a hard time for everyone in the world, and so what I'm attempting to do is to work to heal those connections that were lost, broken, or sometimes they weren't even there to begin with. So everyone needs some time to actually connect back with each other. And we also need to connect out with the world. And so the forest bathing is the central core of my business, and that is forest and nature therapy sessions that I hold either on my farm or out in nature. It could be at a state park, it could be at a local park, it could be in your backyard if you want an individual session. As long as there is something green, some trees, some ground that we can touch, there are so many different things that happen when a human goes out into nature. And this practice is based on Shinrin-yoku, which is a Japanese practice. It's actually part of their national healthcare system. And Shinrin-yoku literally translates into bathing in the forest air or forest bathing. So you probably have heard that. I know that Martha Stewart just wrote an article about forest bathing and why doctors are prescribing walks in nature at this time. So what my goal is to just get you out there, and then rather than mindfulness, which is a term that we hear a lot nowadays, I'm going to bring you into your body. It's an embodiment experience. Rather than being up here in your head, you down into your senses. And so if you want to play along with me for a minute right now, we're going to do a moment of embodiment. And because all of us in this room are sighted individuals, 80% of our sensory input that our mind deals with on a daily basis comes from our sight. So I'm going to ask you all, if you feel comfortable, to go ahead and close your eyes down. And as you close your eyes down, I just want you to come into this room, into this moment, just arrive here. And give your body whatever it needs to just feel comfortable in this moment. Just be here. Maybe a deep breath, maybe adjust your head, your neck, your back a little bit. Take another deep breath. And begin to notice the sounds around you. Sound of the air. What's the quietest sound that you can hear? And now begin to notice what you're feeling. Maybe it's the seat beneath you or your feet on the floor, or perhaps it's an item of clothing. Notice what that feels like right now. And now notice what you're smelling. Maybe take a deep breath in through your nose. Maybe it's the coffee aroma that's filling the room, getting us all going this morning. And then I'm going to ask you to maybe taste the air. Just open are seeing when you open your eyes is also seeing you. And so in your own time, go ahead and open your eyes back to the room. Thanks for playing along. So now we're all very present. We're all here. So I just want to let you know, what I work to do is those connections, building those connections. I do guided sessions for businesses. We also do, it's sort of a team building. I work with individuals. And then the other pieces I threw in there, Butter a Bake Shop and my fashion design, those are things that support my primary business. So I do seasonal art and craft shows, and I do online sales, and this is some of the stuff I do. I do baked goods, I do fashions that are made from repurposed, etc.